Traditional and local diets, like the Mediterranean diet, remain an important cultural legacy. Evolved over generations of local agricultural and fishing practices, they are healthy and sustainable. Yet right now, this invaluable legacy is in danger of being lost, as the demands of modern life, the availability of new foods, and the emergence of fast-eating habits all influence how we eat. And as our diets change, together with less active lifestyles, health problems such as obesity and cardiovascular diseases are increasing. To reverse this trend, it's crucial to promote public health education efforts directed at consumers, who must be adequately informed about the content of food products. Yet the way ingredients are currently shown on the back of food packaging is widely regarded as too detailed and complex for the average consumer to understand at a glance. Research shows that easy-to-read front-of-pack nutritional labeling could help consumers follow healthier and more balanced diets. However, food labeling is a very sensitive matter. Improper labeling can lead to unhealthy choices by consumers, heavy costs for manufacturers, and market distortion. Unfortunately, some states have adopted labeling schemes that discourage the consumption of certain foods or ingredients, based on algorithms that pretend, without solid scientific basis, to classify foods as healthy and unhealthy. And the consequence is that consumers are deterred from purchasing good quality products that are part of the cultural heritage of countries. This approach is flawed, as obesity is not caused by any single food product, but by overall diets and lifestyles. For this reason, Italy believes that a food labeling system should not look to criminalize any food product. Indeed, a good and healthy diet is made up of the right balance of all food groups. Food labeling should be informative and educational, so that consumers can make conscious and responsible choices according to their taste, preferences, and physical condition, which is why color coding is not effective. Color coding and health warnings direct the consumer rather than inform them, leading to them purchasing the same food types regardless of age, gender, or general state of health. Thus, consumers are not stimulated to improve their knowledge about what makes a balanced and varied diet. While clearly the main objective of food labeling should be to provide consumers with adequate information to make them more aware and responsible about their general diet and lifestyle. Front-of-pack labeling should therefore provide nutrient-specific information about a product, such as the amount of energy, fat, saturates, sugar, and salt, as everyone has different requirements depending on their particular state of health. Front-of-pack labeling should also be based on single servings, as the arbitrary reference of 100 grams used by some schemes does not provide consumers with useful information, and penalizes products consumed in small portions. Who would ever consume 100 grams of olive oil or any other traditional oils used as dressing? Every country has its own food culture and traditional products that should never be penalized by misleading package labeling. It is not by depriving consumers of the pleasure of pizza or cake that we can improve the health of citizens. The only real way to help consumers improve their diets is to educate them to make responsible food choices. A healthy lifestyle is about eating in moderation, the right daily balance of various food groups, and some physical activity. To achieve that, we don't need complicated algorithms, just information and education. Nutriform Battery, the taste of being informed.